over 50 million Nigerians are not literate. The European Union and United Nations Spotlight Initiative to eliminate all forms of violence against women and girls in Nigeria is leaving no one behind. The EU-UN Spotlight Initiative had introduced a four-year program, Acceleration of Second Chance Education for Women and Girls. The program is being implemented in Sokoto State by the Grassroots Entrepreneurship Skill Acquisition Initiative, GESA. The program is taking place in two local government areas, that is Benji and Sokoto North.
Women are important in the society, and we want to give them the opportunity to have access to education so that they can make their lives better and make the lives of their family better.
So the ultimate overall goal of this project is to ensure eradication of all forms of gender-based violence, to ensure also empowering women and girls in the community so that the poverty issue that tend to limit girls' participation in school will now be addressed.
There are 75 centers in each local government. The learners are women and girls, some of them victims of gender-based violence, physically challenged, out-of-school children, and other vulnerable groups. Initially, 150 facilitators were trained on how best to guide the learners on basic literacy. At Benji local government, we visited Nupawa and Donkuma villages, where literacy centers were filled to their capacity with learners busy receiving lessons. The story is the same at Sokoto North local government, where women and girls converge on Women Literacy Center to the Nyola to receive lessons. As the learners were enjoying their lessons, then coronavirus pandemic emerged. As the pandemic continued to spread, schools were shut down. Face-to-face and classroom education became impossible. So has the vulnerabilities of women and girls, with a noticeable surge in cases of domestic and sexual abuse in the country. With the coronavirus in place, EU-UN Spotlight Initiative come up with a literacy radio program. The literacy program is aired on Lima Radio Sokoto for the benefit of the learners and other listeners.
Kamar dai yadda muka sheda muku a darasinmu da ya gabata, wannan shiri yana da manufar koyar da rubutu da karatu haɗi da lissafi. Kowa ya san muhimmancin ilimi. Ina fatar mai sauraro ya riga ya ɗauko kayan aikin sa, wato littafin karatu mai suna Jagoran Mai Koyo.
Zainab Sa'idu Yahaya is one of the learners from Sokoto North local government. She now gets her lessons on literacy from radio because coronavirus has made classes impossible.
Bayani ta ainihin makeri akwai wata karama akwati dake dauke da hoto na guda biyu. Hoto na farko hoton kunne. Wannan hoto na kunne yana nuhin ainihin ku saurara.
Sunana Zainab Sa'idu Yahaya. Alhamdulillah dai ina sauraron wannan shirin domin karuwa, kuma ina ganewa, kuma nagode Allah da wannan kungiya saboda ta kawo mana ci gaba, ƴaƴa mata, yara da kuma ƙanana. To dan haka muna godiya ga Allah da ya sa wannan shiri ya zo mana domin mu saurare shi, mu kuma karu da shi, kuma mu amfana da shi. Alhamdulillahi ina dan iya kokartawa in rubuta kuma ina iya kokartawa in karanta kuma ina fahimta sosai. Godiya babu adadi. Saboda mun gode musu kuma muna godiya ga Allah muna godiya ga malamanmu. Bayan na gama wannan karatu ina so in ci gaba in tahi gaba 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 har sai inda Allah ya tsaishe mu ina so in ga karshen biro da takarda.
She listened very well to the program and learned a lot.